Don't you think that counter-terrorism activities fall under the exception of public safety or order and thus allow a legitimate intrusion into a person's privacy?
Yeah. Your Honor, please, we have to go back again to the definition of terrorism.
Can you make it louder, please?
Yes. The definition of terrorism allows an unbridled discretion on the part of the military or the ATC, for that matter, Your Honor, to access, record, or collect information, even private information, Your Honor. Imagine, Your Honor, the order of the court in this case, Your Honor, under Section 16, would not even describe with certainty the things or places to be searched. Under the Constitution, Your Honor's, please, a surveillance such as this is tantamount to a search. And under the Constitution, a search to be reasonable must have probable cause and must describe the things or place to be searched. In this case, Your Honor, is unbridled.
But we must understand the order of surveillance must be authorized by the Court of Appeals upon application, right?
Yes, Your Honor.
So there are safeguards.
In fact, the
test is probable cause before the Court of Appeals could issue an order of surveillance.
In fact, Your Honor, it's an ex parte application. And the basis of probable cause of the Court of Appeals is, for example,
remember
that an offense has been committed.
So you are against the ex parte application.
Well, Your Honor, I'm just saying this, that the standard...
Di ba ganun din ang search warrant? It's an ex parte application?
Yes, Your Honor. The relevance of ex parte is this, Your Honor's, please. That the basis of the court to issue the authorization is an offense has been committed and the effects of the crime can be found in the place to be searched. How can the court know that an offense has been or is about to be committed? In fact, Your Honor, the definition would not give the court standards on what probable cause is, because nobody really knows what the crime being committed or is about to be committed is done, Your Honor's, please. So in that sense, the court authorization actually is without probable cause in the sense that the court has no standards to follow with which to issue the authorization.
What are the standards to follow, Attorney Cormina, Congressman?
Pardon, Paul.
What are the standards that need to be followed? Well, if probable cause is not enough before a Court of Appeals can issue the order of surveillance, what could be your standards?
In terms of search, Your Honor, the probable cause would be that an offense has been committed. And then, of course, the effects of that offense can be found in the place to be searched. In this case, Your Honor, it penalizes intentions. How would the court know that an offense has been committed, Your Honor? And so in that sense, Your Honor's, please, the probable cause of the judge is based on the allegations of the respondents here in this case, Your Honor.
Okay.
And yes, Your Honor.
Don't you think that terrorism is a very, very grave crime against national security and even a crime against the people's security and life? That before they actually have to do any terroristic act, the state has the right to know the information beforehand through a surveillance ordered by the Court of Appeals?
Well, Your Honor, yes, we recognize the fact that terrorism is a grave and serious concern, Your Honor. However, the court has mentioned so many decisions that it's not a question of expediency. That interest must be, compelling state interest even, must be narrowed down, tailored narrowly by the law. Any important compelling interest, if the respondents wishes to do that, must be in consonance with the Constitution, Your Honor. So even if they claim, yes, it's very important, it cannot be said, Your Honor, that it because it's important, it's a serious concern, the fundamental rights of others can be violated because of the state interest at hand, Your Honor. The court will surely strike down a law that just because using the concern or the the gravity of the crime will violate fundamental rights, Your Honors.
Can you honestly believe that the prevention of the commission of a terroristic act can be properly done without surveillance and interception?
Thank you, Your Honor. Actually, I think the prevention of terrorism need not be through a law like the ATA, which is unnecessarily sweeping as to infringe on protected rights, Your Honors. Surveillance, in fact, can be done by state, and it's in the Constitution, it's all in the law. However, in this case, Your Honor, an unbridled discretion, any mode, any personal information, using any mode against any person, Your Honor, is really too much of a power given to the ATC, Your Honor. It violates not only unreasonable searches and seizure, but also the right to privacy. And even if it is important to catch a criminal, whether terrorist or not, that surveillance must be done, the Constitution requires that basic rights must be followed, basic steps must be followed. You see, Your Honor, surveillance, if we connote it as a search, the presumption against a search is that it's for the part of government to prove that the search is necessary.
Can you not just consider this as a matter of evidence that if properly excluded, the court can exclude?
Well, in this case, Your Honor, because of the vagueness and overbreadth of the law, the court doesn't even know whether the things or effects that were seized are part, because you see, it didn't even describe the things to be seized. Under the surveillance provision in Section 16, there is no plain view, Your Honor. There is no plain view in the sense that the moment you're surveilled, all information is quote unquote plain view in the sense that it can be taken by the ATC, Your Honor, even of personal information that is not in any way related to the offense, can still be collected and recorded by the ATC, Your Honor. So in that sense, we contend that we understand the concern for terrorism, but it must not be to the detriment and violation of fundamental rights.
Is the probable cause standard not enough safeguard?
Well, the mention of probable cause seems to portray that there is probable cause. For example, Your Honor, a ATC goes to the court and says, well, we have a probable cause that an offense is being committed, for example, and that the things to be seized is in that place.
But the probable cause must be established at least then through the eyes of the judge issuing the order. Hindi lang, there is a probable cause that the act was committed.
Yes,
there must be something behind that.
So the judge will now ask, what offense has been committed?
So are you not comfortable that the Court of Appeals will issue the order on a probable cause?
No, it can't in that sense, Your Honor, because the Court of Appeals will say, so what offense has been committed? Oh, it's an act that was intended. It's an intention, Your Honor.
Can you provide a safe standard, an acceptable and reasonable standard?
For us, Your Honor, the Section 4 actually cannot be cured by any reasonable standard.
Ah, okay. So Section 4 cannot be cured by any reasonable standard.
Honor. Even an IRR cannot
cure. The definition of the acts there cannot be cured by any possible reasonable standard.
Especially in an IRR, Your Honor, because the IRR can go behind the law. And IRRs can be changed anyway, while the law cannot be changed. So it is not for the IRR to provide safe standard, Your Honor, because IRRs are just not the laws that Congress has passed. So even if the IRR tried to cure, the law does not require it. So therefore, the ATC can always say, well, it's not in the law. And anyway, if you want the IRR, can
be... Okay, Attorney Criminalis, let's go to another point.